Hey there! Thank you very much for joining us in this Azure how-to video. Today we learn how to quickly, and in a few minutes, create a virtual machine using the Azure portal. And for that, we have the awesome Jerry Steele here with us that is going to show us how to do that. So thank you very much for being here, Jerry.
Thanks for having me, Leon. So yeah, we're talking about virtual machines today. Azure has a ton of different virtual machine configurations for whatever you're trying to do, whether you're trying to do a small hobby website, we've got configurations for that. If you're trying to move an entire enterprise into an Azure data center, we have that too. Let's go on the small side today. We're going to quickly create a virtual machine and then look at how to connect to that virtual machine.
Cool, let's get to it.
Great, so I'm in the Azure portal and I'm going to say create a resource. I'm going to go ahead and do an Ubuntu server. So when you create a virtual machine, we ask you a series of questions about configurations, right? And so we have some very basic information, and then there's a complete set of information. How many data disks do you want? Networking options, management options. We're going to fire through it today and do it as fast as we can. First, we're going to tell Azure what's the sort of project details of this thing. What's the subscription? What's the billing information that we need? And then the resource group. And that's almost like a folder for the resources, for related resources. So when I create a virtual machine, it has a NIC, it's got disks, and it's got storage. We put all those things in like a folder, basically, that we call a resource group. And then I can create all those. I can make a copy of that. I can manage that folder all together. Here's all the things that go together. I can provide permissions to that folder, and I can delete that whole thing when I'm done.
Oh, nice.
So after this, I'm going to delete that resource group, and everything goes away. Great. Let's go ahead, and I'm going to give this virtual machine a name. This is new VM 17. I can decide where in the world I want it to be. Do I want it to be in Australia? We're in the lovely Pacific Northwest, so I'm going to go ahead and put it near us here. Great, then I get to choose what image I want, what operating system. Do I want Windows, do I want Linux? Or we have from the Azure Marketplace, you can pick tons of different things. I think there's 4,000 different VM images, things like that. Great. I can choose the size, the configuration. Do I want one CPU? Do I want 100 CPUs? How much memory do you want? All those options are here. I'm gonna go ahead and pick the default. Great, let's go ahead and put in a username and an SSH key. And then I can go through and I can then say, how many ports do I want to open, right? And so by default, we say none. We're going to lock down access to that virtual machine, limit the connectivity to it. But then let's go ahead and say, I know I'm going to want to SSH this machine. So let's go ahead and open up SSH. If it were a web server, I might want to enable some other things too. Great, let's go ahead and review and create. And so, again, what you see here is that we had a very limited amount of information that we had to fill out, and then the system goes away and says, did you do it right? Do we have all the information we need to create that virtual machine? Which apparently we don't, right?
What happened?
I went through it so fast, I forgot to actually put in the SSH key. So I can just jump back here and say, oh, yep, there's the problem. SSH key can't be empty. I'm going to go ahead and fill one out. Oops, I missed it. Not that one. I want it to be this one.
But and the beauty of what happened is like the system told you it failed and here's where you need to,
that's
go to
right.
fix it.
That's right. So here's where the problem is. This thing is blank. It shouldn't be blank. I put in something that didn't look like an SSH key and it said, nope, you can't have that. I then put in something that was an SSH key and it worked just fine. So great. So since we hit review and create, it's going to go back and double check our work, make sure that Azure's ready to provision that virtual machine. It's going to come back and say, yes, it's ready. It's ready to go. Validation passed. So I'm going to hit create, and on we go.
Cool. That's all?
That's it. Yep. So again, there's a ton of configuration options in there to make that VM exactly how I want it. But if I just want to get a default virtual machine, I want to try something out very quickly, very simple to get started with.
That's cool. So you provided basically the project, where you want to put it, a name, open a few ports, selected like the image and like the size, and that's it.
That's it. Yep, pretty quick. So now I want to keep track of how that's going, and Azure gives you a sample of, what's the process? What's going on with the deployment? And like I said, when you create a virtual machine, tons of things get created. You get network interface cards, you get storage, you get the actual virtual machine, and so you want to keep track of what that process is. And so the system will let you know what the process is. You've got control over it. If everything goes swimmingly well, which it usually does, you can track it here. If for something does go wrong, you can actually see a very nice error message and figure out how to triage that. Is it another configuration you need to set, or whatever has happened.
That's good, but the important thing is that I'm always informed of what's going on.
That's right.
So I can see almost near real time what's going on with my provisioning, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. So that's going to need a couple more seconds to provision. Let's go ahead and connect to a different virtual machine.
Sounds good.
And I happen to have one. Oh, well, we can, let's go crazy. Let's see if we can connect to that virtual machine.
That's great.
So, okay, so I created a virtual machine. I opened up port 22 to it. I put in an SSH key. So hopefully everything should go well. I'm gonna go ahead and hit connect to this virtual machine. And what will come up is this pane that gives you all the information you need to connect to it. Here's the public IP address for that virtual machine. Here's the port number that we opened in while we were creating it. Again, we took the default SSH port of 22. We could have configured it to be something else, but since we didn't, we're gonna keep the defaults here. And it gives us the connection string that I then need to copy into my terminal program. Now I can go and I can open up a PuTTY or the Windows subsystem for Linux to open up a terminal program, but the Azure portal actually has a terminal right here embedded in it. It's called the Azure Cloud Shell. So I'm gonna pop this open here. I copied the connection string. I'm gonna open up the Cloud Shell. And so what that gives me a full Linux environment right within the Azure portal that I can then use to connect to the virtual machine.
And it's fully authenticated, right?
Fully authenticated, that's right. I've logged into the portal, so Cloud Shell knows me. It knows what subscriptions and resources I have access to. Great, let's see if I can actually SSH into that machine. And once I do that, I've done all the key work and I'm in the machine and I'm doing my work.
That's really great. And you copied that that connection string from that panel, you put it here and now you're connected.
I'm doing my work, that's right.
That's awesome.
Yep, in and out and on with my day.
That's great, thank you very much, Jerry.
Thanks for having me.
And thanks everyone for watching this video. Please try this in the portal, portal.azure.com. Also leave us a comment in the video or follow us on Twitter. Look forward to seeing you in our next video. Thank you so much for watching.